You know, this whole time I've been the guy saying, oh, I predicted the Canucks to lose in five. So, for them to lose game number four, it's fine. I've been the guy saying the entire time that my bracket is somewhat important, which is why I would not be super upset if this team lost, since they already won a game. But man, this one hurts. Yeah, this one really, really does hurt. Because I'm gonna say it right out front here. I think the better team lost. I really do. I think that the better team in Game 4 lost Game 4. And it was all started in the third period. I mean, you want to talk about officiating, you want to talk about missed calls, you want to talk about the slash that Edler did on Stetcher that put Marchessault in the box. There's a lot here that we can go over when it comes to officiating, and I haven't been touching nearly as much on the refs as other people have in other realms of social media, but man, in my opinion, the moment the Adam Gaudette hook in the third period went uncalled, that was the beginning of the end. And even though the Canucks looked so good, so good at certain parts of that game, a few bad bounces the other way and they're down 5-3. So, this one hurts, it really does, even though I am a Vancouver Canucks fan and I will cheer for this team till the day I die, probably. I was saying the entire time that I had them losing in five, but to actually see it go out like this, man, it hurts. So let's go over the notes that I wrote down for this game as the game was going on, because earlier on, to start things off, we had ourselves a lot of really good opportunities. Game 4, Markstrom had to make some saves early on, then Chandler Stephenson, he probably had the best chance early on. He had a wraparound that almost went in the first period where the Canucks ended up not clearing it and the Knights missed the net on the rebound. The Canucks eventually had a bad change where Mark Stone had a mini breakaway to the goal and he shot it wide. The Canucks also had a too many men penalty that they had as well. That was like the third time they've done that. Seriously, Vancouver, if you're only going to have one more game to play, please stop taking too many men calls. That one was kind of weird because Alex Edler and Troy Stetcher both came onto the ice, but it looked like Fantenberg was going to go off, and he didn't. He kind of turned around as the play was coming back the other way, so even though the Knights were rushing into the Canucks zone, they still had a weird change that caused the too many men penalty. And Pacioretty scored early on. It was not really great to see. That was the 1-0 goal in the series. It was 5-hole. Mott didn't block it. You could see Markstrom, he was really frustrated on that initial 1-0 goal. But then Chandler Stephenson, man, that guy who had the really good wraparound attempt, he came in and he took himself a penalty where Elias Pettersson was able to come in and take control immediately after the power play started. This one was really, really nice. Hughes to Miller to Petey. Petey waits for the shooting lane to open up and he goes top glove on Marc-Andre Fleury. It's the first game-tying goal of the entire series because every other game we've played, either Vancouver gets a few goals to go up and then Vegas can't tie it, or Vegas gets a shutout. This is the first time we had a tying scenario, and at this point, it's 1-1, and I'm thinking to myself, man, it really feels like the next goal is going to win. It feels like next goal wins here because we haven't had a tie game situation where a team has come back to tie it before, so this feels like a completely new ball game that we're playing here. Eventually, though, after that Petey goal, we had ourselves a few more stuff going on. It was Chandler Stephenson, that guy who took the penalty. He had a go-ahead goal. Nice back-and-forth passing play on the rush. Stephenson over to the far side. I believe it was Carrier who sent it all the way wing-to-wing back to Stephenson, who shoots it. It's in. Markstrom didn't see it. Plain and simple, it's 2-1. At this point, I'm kind of frustrated because I'm like, okay, that means Vegas is going to win, right? But then, Elias Pettersson. Elias Pettersson gets a breakaway, and in this moment in my head, it clicks. Oh my gosh, we have ourselves a chance to come back. We're gonna win this game. No! Ah, Marc-Andre Fleury, man. He made the save. He tried backhanding it up high. Fleury made the save. And then Besser eventually redeems all of my worries because Besser sends it over to Horvat. And Horvat takes a tight shot. No, Marc-Andre Fleury made the save as well. Oh my gosh, come on. Fleury, man, making these saves. Brock Besser, though, on that one play that I just mentioned, he's looked really good, where he fights himself forward, goes heavy on the forecheck, battles it out down low to get the puck back, and centers it over for Horvat, who ends up getting saved off. The Canucks started off period number two with a Tyler Toffoli chance, but that one was saved. And then Mark Stone the other way around. He comes in dipsy-doodling his way to the net, almost getting a mini sort of breakaway shootout-looking opportunity on Jacob Markstrom, but that one was saved by the long legs of Markstrom. But then, Bo Horvat. My gosh, Bo Horvat with the goal here. In the second period, he kind of wills this one to go in because this was a situation where the Canucks were overloading, winning those battles, and Edler took the puck at the point. He drove the shot, the tip over by Miller, the rebound out in front for Horvat. It's actually Fleury who kicks it in, which is kind of unfortunate, but that is Bo Horvat's league-leading goal again. I think he has 10 on the year so far, which is absolutely crazy. 10 goals in the postseason, number one in the entire NHL. And the game is tied yet again, so we'll see how things go. Oh my gosh, what the heck was that? Nate Schmidt with a point-blank opportunity, but Markstrom saves him. He stamped the puck to the ice with his left toe. Eventually, though, we had a few other opportunities, like where Elias Pettersson got absolutely robbed in front by Marc-Andre Fleury. Toffoli brought it to the net, and Petey on the rebound. It was an absolutely crazy save. That's classic Fleury right there, with the desperation dive with the glove making that stop there. Besser and Gaudette had a 2-on-1 as well, but Gaudette missed the net on the short side. Gaudette was kind of buzzing this entire game, man. He had opportunities, but he just wasn't able to get one to go. Mott then had a save. Beagle on the rebound. Marc-Andre Fleury made another save as well. There were a whole bunch of really good opportunities at this point in the second period, and the Canucks kind of just took over. On the power play, Pettersson had a bomb that was point-blank robbed by Fleury. And then it was Quinn Hughes with a give-and-go play, sending it out to the hash marks for Tyler Toffoli, who goes over the shoulder. The Vancouver Canucks have the 3-2 lead in the second period, and at this point, I'm like, wow. Every time the Canucks have had the lead in this series, they've won the game. They're going to win this game, and they have looked like the better team doing it. My goodness, what a rewarding goal over here. It's Miller, it's Hughes, it's Toffoli getting on the board here to give the Canucks the lead. And the penalties felt like that too. Chandler Stephenson got another penalty. Edler gave the Canucks a power play by high-sticking Stetcher. They thought it was Marchessault. They didn't score on those power plays, which felt okay in the moment because, hey, they were still up by one, right? It felt okay to not score on the power play, but now in hindsight, man, they should have scored on the power play. But in the third period, things started off a little bit weird because the Vegas Golden Knights kind of put it into another gear. We've seen the Knights charge over in period number two, but this time it was in period number three, because Nate Schmidt had a few really good opportunities immediately, and then Gaudette gets hooked, and there's no penalty. The play continues, Schmidt gets the puck again from the point, he bombs it in, it's a tie game, and I'm thinking about, okay, if they call the hook on Gaudette, that goal doesn't go in, it's another Canucks power play. And then soon afterwards, the Canucks, they try to get the lead back. It's such a good shift from Mott and Sutter. Amazing opportunities. They get a full line change. And Horvat to Vertanen, he missed the net. Really, really good immediate chances over there by Vancouver for the span of about 2 minutes or so. But then once Vegas breaks the puck out, they get it to the goal, and it goes off of Pacioretty's skate and in. It's a Vegas lead off of a really weird bounce that probably shouldn't have happened. Pacioretty with his second in the game. Then, immediately afterwards, it's Pacioretty who has the puck behind the net. The puck deflected over the goal. Markstrom didn't see it, and Pacioretty, who's behind the goal line, sends it over into the crease. Karlsson is there. He buries it. That's another bad bounce because it completely goes out of the realm of play for Jacob Markstrom's point of view. It's 5-3 Vegas as soon as you could blink your eyes, and it does not feel good because just a few minutes earlier, the Canucks had the lead. The Canucks had chances. The Canucks got robbed by Fleury several times, and that's the ultimate score to the end of the game. Marc-Andre Fleury then took a penalty towards the end of the game as well. The Canucks had a power play. They were 6-on-4 for a little bit, but they just got robbed. Marc-Andre Fleury had another really good stretch of saves. Jacob Markstrom lets in 5 goals in this one. I'm sorry, man, but even though a lot of those goals weren't his fault, it still isn't a good look. This was a game where even though the result that I thought would happen did happen, it really hurts to talk about because the Knights, even though they played well, I thought the Canucks played better. And you could say I'm a homer, but I've been so self-deprecating towards the Vancouver Canucks the entire playoffs. This is the only time throughout the entire series of games that they have played against Vegas, Minnesota, and St. Louis where I'm saying that the better team lost. And now it's 3-1. So, yeah. Game 5, man. Game 5. Talk to me in the comments what you thought about this game. I hope you enjoyed this video. So that's Trolls99. And bye.